All those who are joining us who are saying salam, wa alaykum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you for those who came here, and thank you for those who are online. Salam alaykum wa alaykum salam. It's okay, children. Children, they need to attend, inshallah. They are innocent ones. They bring barakah to the gathering. Yeah, that's one. Hey, wallah. Not like me. Inshallah, we say something before we start the zikr about this important night. مدد يا أولياء الله عينونا بعون الله وكونوا عونا لنا بالله عسى نحظى بفضل الله مدد سيد الشيخ محمد ناظم عبد الحق سيد الشيخ محمد عبد ربان طريقتنا الصحبة والخير في الجميع. This night, this month is a blessed month. Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. And also there's a hadith ma'thurat, although they are, a lot of them are labeled as da'if hadith. They call them da'if hadith. No, the hadith is not da'if. There's Prophet's hadith is never da'if. But the da'if is a description that there is something in the hadith. There's maybe a narrator that had memory problems. Something like that. So that's why. But in all the times of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, all the ahadith al-di'af were taken and applied fi fada'il a'mal. Our uncle prayed 6 rak'ahs after Salat al-Maghrib, Salat al-Awabin. Salat al-Awabin, Imam Nawawi mentions it that it is in the hadith da'if. And he practiced it, and it is said that one prayer after Maghrib 6 rak'ah equal to Allah gives you the reward of 12 years of ibadah. Like that. So this night is like that. This night there's many hadith that for certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the hadith that are sihah and are the ones that are accepted by everyone, is that this night is the night where Allah forgives all sin. In Allah la yattali'u ala ibadi, aw kama qala an-nabi. Allah looks on this night, not Allah. Allah is not looking, and Allah is not seeing us. Allah is always seeing us. But this is a special looking. This is a special looking of rahmah and maghfirah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And He forgives everyone. He forgives everyone on this night except from Ummat al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, except a mushrik or a mushahin. Mushahin, one who has hate or enmity in their hearts. One who has, his heart is full of negativity, enmity. It's charged with hatred towards anything or anyone. This will prevent us from receiving. You see why forgiveness is so important? When Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu arda, the one who was a poor man and the recipient of one of his sadaqah, he was giving him like a salary, giving him all the time to look after him. He was actually spreading the false fake news about Sayyidina Aisha radiallahu anhu arda. And when Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq heard this, he said, I'm not going to give him anymore. Okay, it's his daughter. But then when he heard the verses that don't you love for Allah to forgive you, he said, he continued giving him. So now we are asking Allah to forgive us. We should ourselves forgive. Don't care. Somebody wronged you. Somebody took your right. Somebody infringed on your inheritance. Somebody said something wrong to you. Somebody, take it out of your heart. Say, Ya Rabbi, I am forgiving. I'm forgetting. I want your forgiveness. We are all sinful ones. Because that prevents us from reaching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's forgiveness. If our hearts are full of negative feelings, they prevent us from reaching. And this month when we say, you know, Rajab Shahrullah, they say also this hadith daif. Okay, Sha'ban is not important, they want to say. Although Prophet ﷺ said that this is a month that most people are heedless from. Used to fast a lot in this month. So much so that sometimes they think he was fasting the whole entire month. And then when asked about that, he said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at the deeds of human beings, and I want, when Allah is looking at my deeds, to look at it when I'm fasting. Look who Sayyidina Sahib Thani Athnain, Sahib Sayyidina Jibreel fil Mi'raj is saying this, saying about that Allah, he wants, he's teaching us. Prophet has no dhanb, he's infallible, but he's teaching us to seek Allah's forgiveness and to find in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has nafahat, it's called nafahat, means he has special times that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts the deeds from, that forgives from. فَتَعَرَّضُ لَهَا النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, look for them. Look for these special moments. Look for these special people. Look for these special days and nights. And seek to maximize your rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on these nights. So this is Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, also in another narration, he says that this month is my month. Shahri, Sha'ban, Shahri. Why? They say also life. But it is known from the tafsir that in Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah said, وَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا. It is well known that this verse was revealed in Sha'ban. That the verse of Salah ala Nabi was revealed in the month of Sha'ban. That should be Eid. The whole month should be Eid. Because look what Allah is not just revealed it. Look what Allah is giving us when we make salawat. When we increase our salawat upon Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, look what he's giving to the Ummah of Habib. For one salawat, 10. وَالَّذِي يُصَلِّ عَلَيْكُمْ لِيُخْرِجَكُمْ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. When he's taking you out of darkness into guidance and light. So yes, this is the month of prophets. This is the month of Salah ala Nabi. This is the month of praising Sayyidina Muhammad. And Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah have always, they tightened their belts. They tightened their belts, start tightening their belts from the month of Rajab. And when Sha'ban comes, they tighten it even more. And they get ready before Ramadan comes. They are in a pure state. And so they do their extra adhkar and extra qiyam and recitation of Quran and tasadduq. In Shafi'i madhab, it is recommended to give your, like most people like to give their, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, their zakat. They like to give it in Ramadan because they want to maximize the reward. But Imam Shafi'i, he recommended giving it in Sha'ban so that the poor people, they don't have to worry in Ramadan. You give it to them in Sha'ban, and people in need, they don't have to worry. They're already ready for Ramadan. So this is something practiced in many countries, Shafi'i madhab. They usually give their zakats in the month of Sha'ban. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us to do good deeds. If you can stay up, if you're working, it's you're working what you can do. Do as much as you can, even pray two rak'ahs tahajjud. after you leave here, or wake up before Fajr, maybe 10 minutes, half an hour for the Adhan, and pray a few rak'ats, something. For those who can, our Shaykh used to, Grand Shaykh Mawlana, Shaykh Nazim, Shaykh Abdullah, they pray 100 rak'ats on this night. And they usually pray it with 10 Qul Huwa Allahu Ahads in each rak'ah. So that's 1,000 Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad. Later on, they make rukhsa. They said you can pray 100, but pray it with 2 quls in the first rak'ah and 1 in the second rak'ah. Too quickly, yani. And then you can finish the Qul Huwa Allahu Ahad, 1,000, you can finish them on the tasbih when you can, inshallah. Inshallah, give sadaqah, you fast if you can fast. It is a blessed evening, inshallah. Wa min Allahi tawfiq, bi hurmati al-habib, bi hurmati al-fatiha. Salli ala Muhammad.